In the Buddha's time, there was a certain man who had an opportunity to listen to the Buddha's teachings. Afterwards, he decided to ordain. Each morning, he performed his monk duties of going for bintabat, or making alms rounds. However, owing to his past karma, he rarely had enough to eat. On some days, he would only have a few spoonfuls of rice. This made it difficult for him to stay focused enough to remain as a monk. After being hungry for many days, his mind started to wander. Out of weakness, his mind settled on an idea that deep inside he knew was towing the line between right and wrong. He decided to collect alms at his old house. His former wife, hoping to make merit, but also hoping to entice her former husband to return to life as a householder, eagerly invited him in, saying, "Come in, venerable sir. I will provide you with all the food you used to eat when you lived here." So she and his former servants offered the young monk all his favorite foods. But before he left, his former wife said, "Please feel free to stop by anytime you need food, even if it's every day. I'm more than happy to serve you. No one knows what you like more than I do." And so, the monk made it a habit to stop by almost daily, so that his former wife could continue to serve him his favorite foods. One day, the monk stopped by, but no one answered the door. He kept knocking and knocking, but there was no response. After a while, his former wife came out and said, "I'm sorry, I didn't know you were coming today. I was offering food to an elder monk who walked by for bintabat. Please wait a few minutes for him to finish, and I'll serve you next." The young monk felt heat rise into his head. He felt jealous and possessive. This was his former wife, and this was his former house. As he watched the elder monk walk away, a flood of emotions overtook him. His former wife noticed this and smiled inside. Things were going according to her plan. She said, "Venerable sir, please come inside. I will prepare all your favorite foods and your usual seat." And so, his former wife served him. However, owing to his swirling thoughts and intense emotions, the meal was not as rewarding as it usually was. The conflicted monk went back to his guti, where he tossed and turned all night. He kept thinking, "Why should I remain a monk and suffer, when I could go back and be with my former wife, who knows what I like and can take care of me? If I don't go back, she could find another to take care of." When his fellow monks learned of his feelings, they took him to ask for advice from the Buddha. The Buddha said,
"Is it true what they say, monk? Are you tempted to disrobe by thoughts of the wife you left?"
"Yes, sir, I am."
"Monk, why is it you feel this way when in the past you once had your head cut off for this very woman?"
And upon their request, the Buddha told the story of the past. Once upon a time, when Brahmadatta reigned in Benares, the Bodhisat was born in the village of Kasi and made a living as a robber. Through his actions, he was infamous for being bold and strong as an elephant. No man could catch him. One day, After he robbed a rich merchant who was a close friend of the king, the merchant, along with many others who had been robbed, petitioned the king to capture the master robber. The king ordered many soldiers to apprehend the robber. Eventually, the robber was captured, and the whole city was relieved. The king ordered him whipped in the town square in front of everyone and condemned him to be executed. In that same town lived a famous courtesan named Sama. She was a favorite of the king. She had a suite of 500 female slaves and charged rich men 1,000 pieces for a night with her. She had countless nobles and merchants as her clients. When the robber was tied to a post in the town square, Sama came out to see what the commotion was about. She was immediately overcome by his height, his muscular frame, his good looks, and his confidence. She fell in love with him and desired him above all else. She sent some of her slaves to find out if she could buy the robber's freedom. She was told that the king had ordered a public execution, and someone had to die. If she wanted this robber, she would have to find a willing substitute to take his place, and pay the executioner a bribe of 1,000 gold coins. There was one particularly older merchant who was intensely in love with Sama. He would stop by every day to bring her gifts and 1,000 gold coins. Sama, however, had no feelings for him, and only allowed him to continue his visits due to his gifts and attention. So, on the day that she received news from the executioner, she waited for the love-struck merchant to stop by. She took his gift of 1,000 gold coins and placed it in her lap and started crying. The merchant, worried about her, asked what was wrong. Sama told him that the robber in the town square was actually her brother, and he was about to be executed. She told him that if someone brought the executioner a letter and 1,000 gold pieces, he would let his prisoner free. She told him that she couldn't find anyone to take the letter and the money to the executioner. The merchant quickly saw his opportunity and said, "I will do it for you. I would do anything for your love. Give me the letter, and I will pay the 1,000 gold coins for your brother myself. Never fear, I'm here to serve you." Sama then said, "I always knew that you were the one who loved me most. Take this letter, and when you give it to the executioner, give him the money, and tell him you came willingly, and that you know the plan." When the merchant arrived, he gave the executioner the letter. Having not read it, as he trusted Sama completely, he didn't know that it said, "I am to die in the place of the robber." The executioner read the letter and said, "Are you sure?"
"Yes."
"And you do this willingly?"
"Yes."
"Where's the payment?"
"Here, sir."
"So be it."
And with that, the executioner and his assistant gagged the merchant and put a bag over his head. They then took the robber away and delivered him to Sama's waiting servants. And later that night, in front of a large crowd, the love-struck merchant had his head cut off. Sama and the freed robber proceeded to spend every day and every night enjoying sensual pleasures with each other. Sama stopped entertaining guests and spent all her time with the handsome robber. However, as time passed, the robber was no longer blinded by lust and carnal pleasures. One day, after a pleasure session, a thought occurred to him.
If this woman was willing to send a man to his death because of her love for another man, what will happen to me if she falls in love with another man? She'll have me put to death and take pleasure in the new man. This woman is treacherous, and I must no longer dwell here. I must escape. However, I will not go away empty-handed. I will take as much as I can carry.
So he waited, and one day, after a pleasure session, he said to her,
"My love, we've spent many days indoors. I feel like a bird locked in a cage. Wouldn't it be wonderful to make love in the forest? If you would, adorn yourself with all your expensive finery, for that makes you even more attractive to me. And let us go away to the forest, where we can find intense pleasure."
Sama, blinded by love, much like the love-struck merchant was with her, could not see through this plot. She readily agreed and wanted nothing more than to pleasure her lover. She dressed in all the finest clothes and expensive jewelry that she received as gifts from rich customers. They got into a wagon and headed for the woods. Once they were alone, the robber moved to embrace her. He wrapped his strong arms around her and squeezed. He squeezed her harder and harder until she could barely breathe. She squeaked out,
"Lover, please be more gentle. I can barely breathe."
However, the robber only squeezed harder until he thought he'd successfully killed her. Thinking that she was dead and his plan successful, the robber stole everything of value and took off into the forest. Unbeknownst to the robber, Sama had not died, but simply lost consciousness. When she came to, she saw that all of her jewelry was missing. The robber was nowhere to be found. Still blinded by love, she assumed that he must have gotten too excited and embraced her too strongly. Then, thinking she died, he must have feared for his safety and run off with her jewelry. She called out to him,
my love, I'm not dead, come back to me."
Sama, stricken by loss, stopped wearing nice garments and barely ate or showered. She collected as much money as she could and sent her 500 slaves to all the neighboring towns and cities with a quest. They were to memorize a poem and recite it at large gatherings in every city and town. And so, the slaves went off. One slave happened to travel to a city where the robber had settled. She began her poem.
"On a beautiful day, lovers together were Sama and her man, behind a large tree. A strong embrace ended in a swoon, but not death. Sama, alive, waits for thee."
The robber, hearing this, came near, but did not reveal himself. He said,
"Whether alive or dead, her I do not want. Her eyes rove, and her heart falls in love. For a man, she would betray another, and send the fool to his death. Me too, Sama would betray, were I not to flee far away."
And with that, the robber skillfully disappeared into the crowd. When the female slave returned, she relayed the message to Sama. This broke Sama's heart, and eventually she returned to her prior profession. And the Buddha concluded the Jataka by saying, "At that time, this monk was the rich merchant. His former wife was Sama, and I myself was the robber." At the end of this, the worldly-minded monk was able to penetrate the suffering inherent in following one's desires and attained enlightenment as a Sotapanna. What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.